the 14th World University Championships taking place in Poznan for the third time. This city in Poland, well known for its rowing venue. 338 athletes from 26 countries, five continents all competing here. And Poland have big ambitions, led by Anna Wierbowska, who will fight for victory with her sister.
I feel fresh, I feel ready and, you know, hungry for racing. Being in Poland, I think the whole team has that pressure of performing well.
Anna Maria missed out on the podium in Rio, finishing fourth in the B final of the pairs race. Anna will graduate in a few months in sports management. She knows this course incredibly well. That's got to be an advantage.
I had my first competition when I was 12 or 13 years old, so I race here a few times a year. So I know exactly if it's side wind, headwind, where I should push during the race course. So, you know, this is the advantage for me.
Anna, who quite happy to admit she was overweight when she was younger, then took up rowing as she had an affinity with the water. And she feels that being with her sister, growing together, developing their rowing together, has given them a huge amount of power.
We really don't have to communicate. We don't have to speak during racing because we know exactly what we want to do. And we know each other so well that, you know, many things that are a problem on other boats are becoming our strength on our boat.
Now, the British University team topped the medal table at the last World University Championships in France, and they come with high expectations and a well-prepared team led by Lee Butcher.
Our team is a young team, it's a developmental team, and we very much see the World University Rowing Championships as a sort of critical event in our long-term athlete development pathway. Our team in Gravelines 2 years ago featured Karen Bennett, and Karen was rowing in Rio this year and got an Olympic silver medal. So for us, this is a really important event.
One of the crew from the eight last year that took the gold medal, William Waugh. He's changed boats this time to the men's four. And Will completed a master's in public policy at Cambridge and has been training for 16 months for this.
We know there's very good people here in our event. The Polish four, they all went to Rio to the Olympics. So, you know, we respect our opposition and we know they're going to be very, very good.
For him, this event is a unique one.
I think it's very special to like really stretch your brain and mind in one section of your life and then the other one just stretch your body to the limit. And this is like the only event where you have to compete doing those two things at the same time.
Stefan Kruger symbolises the high level of competition here at the World University Championships. The 27-year-old German rower didn't shine in Rio, collapsing across the line with Marcel Hacker, but he's a top-level athlete and will compete in the double sculls here at Poznan.
Ich mag die Strecke hier. Ich bin hier Weltmeister geworden.
He says he loves the course here.
Europameister.
This is where he became world champion. He became European champion as well.
Als Abschluss, egal wie Rio.
And he thought this would be a nice finish to the season after Rio. A great way to conclude. Well, Stefan studied nautical logistics at Wismar last year, and despite good support from the university, combining academia and sport is not easy. And he wants to dedicate his performance here to his university. He says, my initial intention was to give something back to the university. They've been so supportive of my efforts over the years.
And
so he wanted to come here to these championships one last time to compete for the university. Just a way of saying thank you to them. Well, the experienced rower is the leader of the German team and certainly a role model for the younger athletes. Timo Pointek is one of them. They share the same rowing style on the water and appreciates the relationship. Stefan saying It's really fun for him. He's learning a lot, and that makes me happy, says Stefan. And perhaps I can show him how to try new things, maybe change a few of the technical issues he has. Well, the 24-year-old Timo Pointek, a student of public administration in Wiesbaden, he's aware of the privilege of rowing with one of the world-class athletes at these championships.
He says our
strength perhaps is that we haven't done much rowing together. They've only covered 50Ks in the same boat, but it was evident straight away that they have a fantastic combination.
Ich denke mal, dass wir beide auch sehr, sehr leicht sind für Schwergewichtsrudern.
Not huge for this class, but he's convinced that they won't have any problems competing with the best here. So Stefan discovered rowing at school back in 1998, and then since then his passion for sport has never disappeared. He doesn't know what his future is going to be in rowing, but he'll continue with his masters in Hamburg. But here, he's after medals. We'll see what we can do. He says, if I can get a medal, it'd be great. But to be honest, it's just a great occasion. A lot of fun to mix with all the other students and race with a little bit less pressure. We'll see how the Germans get on.
In 2016, university sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.